Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, my name is Erlin Christine Mutia. Now, I will explain or tell about the journal that I have found and I read. I'm very interested in plants, and I will tell you about the one part of plant, namely roots. I took the example of the Arianthus plants. Since ancient times, humans and plants have a very close relationship. Humans will need energy on Earth, one of which is plants. The more living things, the more energy or things needed to make ends meet. However, if used continuously, it will run out, such as petroleum, gas online, or other. Regarding bioethanol, bioethanol is biomass produced from plants, which will be the less fuel and an alternative ways that can prevent global warming. Regarding bioethanol, bioethanol is a biomass produced from plant, which will be the less fuel and alternative ways that can prevent global warming. Among the many bioethanol, the Arianthus plant is one of the cellulose energy plants which cannot be consumed. Arianthus plants have been used and will continue to be developed into potential green plants that may have bioethanol potential because it has a very large biomass pressure. How can we know that Arianthus plants can become bioethanol and even replace fuel or biomass that is on Earth? The way is to do research, which is by planting Arianthus seeds, and later their development will be seen using Olympus Core BX60 in order to know the root element or root diameter. Why are the root examined? Because the root is one of the foundation of the establishment of plants and will be assisted with stem so that plant can stand firm. In table 1, it can be seen that the roots of the Arianthus plant increase in height in autumn. And in the table 2, the plants continue to grow constantly in winter. It means the Arianthus plant can adapt to the exciting climate. Other evidence is in figures 3A and 3B that the nodal root is covered with a soil seed following the root epidermis, whereas in figure 3C the roots have dense hairs. Metsuo already reported the formation of aerenchyme in the root cortex of submerged Arianthus in Ceylon. Such aerenchyme was well developed in mass nodal roots of Arianthus dug even in the not submerged plants in this study. The fact suggests the Arianthus may have adapted to tropical and subtropical monsoon climates where wet and dry conditions occur periodically. Based on results of research on Arianthus plants, it is very proven that Arianthus plants can be one of the possible candidates for lignocellulosic bioethanol raw material because they can grow continuously or can adapt to surrounding environment and have strong bioethanol or biomass production. Basically, indeed all living things have a close relationship like plants and humans. Plants produce oxygen that is needed by humans to breathe and survive, whereas humans produce carbon dioxide to help plants cook their food to survive as well. So, it is important to protect nature and the environment. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.